Unreal Engine 5 was just released this morning, and it is a game changer. The computer graphic industry will never be the same. Everyone, from game developers to movie makers, are excited to start using Unreal Engine 5. But you're probably wondering why Unreal Engine 5 is such a big deal. Well, in this video, I'm going to go over 5 reasons why Unreal Engine 5 is a game changer.
Number 1 is Unreal's brand new lighting system called Lumen. Since the start of computer graphics, developers have been trying to simulate global illumination. Essentially, global illumination is bounce lighting, which is the extra light that is created from light rays bouncing off of different surfaces. For example, if we have a room with just one light source, which is the window, it doesn't make sense for the room to be pitch black. Instead, light rays from the window will bounce off of the floors and walls to illuminate the entire room indirectly. Movies have been able to use bounce lighting for a while now through the process called path tracing, but it can take a very long time for just a single frame to render. Sometimes these renders can even last for hours. Obviously, this makes it hard to use for video games that require 30 to 120 frames rendered every second. To get around this in the past, game developers have faked global illumination through a process called light baking. Essentially, all the path tracing was rendered before the game is played. This render is then stored in a texture called a light map, which is then overlaid on top of the world to make it look like light is bouncing around in real time, when in reality, it's just a pre-rendered texture. But now the problem is that global illumination is not real time. So as soon as I make a change, our light map is no longer in sync. So we have to rebake the entire environment all over again, which is time consuming. This is why Lumen is such a big deal, since it's true real-time global illumination. So right here we have the same scene, but Lumen is turned on, so there is no baked lighting. And notice how as soon as I start to move this chair around, the light updates in real time. We can even play with how much light is coming through the window dynamically. So let's add in a cube. And we can scale this up and slowly start to block off all the light in the room. And then notice how as soon as I move this, we start to seep in more and more light. And this room is entirely dynamically changing its visibility because of all of that bounce lighting, which was near impossible in Unreal Engine 4. The city sample shows off Lumen pretty well. I can rotate my sun and watch all those buildings illuminate each other through their bounce lighting. Even windows on buildings now give off light. For example, if I grab this car and move it from the window, it starts to cast soft shadows onto the concrete. Reason 2 is nanite. Every object you see in CGI, whether that be in video games or movies, are comprised of tiny flat planes of geometry called polygons. And generally, the more polygons you have in a world, the longer it takes for your computer to render, which can slow down video games. This is why games use a system called a level of detail, or LOD for short. Basically, the further away an object is from the camera, the less polygons it will use to render that object. This makes games run faster since there's less polygons that have to be rendered, but it's a time-consuming process to create all the LODs. Nanite changes this. At a simple level, nanite allows for a dynamic level of detail. This means you can have an object with millions of polygons without any LODs because those polygons dynamically deform, lowering the total amount of polys on the object. This allows for high-poly assets made for movies to be used in video games now. I think it's best to show an example of why this is a big deal. So right in front of you is a donut I made in Unreal Engine, and this donut is made up of about 30,000 different polygons. Here is that same exact donut, but copied and pasted over 100,000 times. And what is insane is that we're not faking any of these donuts with textures or billboards. All these donuts are individual objects that we can move around, rotate, and scale. Maybe one donut is bigger than all the others. A more practical example is the city sample, which is made up entirely of nanite objects. We can see how nanite works by coming up to lit, down to nanite visualization, and triangles. So every color you see is an individual polygon, and we can see more polygons pop in the closer we get to one of the buildings or to any of those objects. For example, this water tower, if I go away, we can see that the water tower loses polys, but when I come up close, it gains more and more polys. Number 3 is the Megascans asset library. What is the point of great features like nanite and Lumen if we don't have any objects to populate our world with? This is where Megascans can help us. Megascans is a library of over 16,000 assets ready to be used automatically in Unreal Engine 5. These assets include 3D objects, plants,
material surfaces, modular objects, and recently they even added customizable trees. And all these objects are photorealistic because they're scanned from real life. The team at Megascans have flew all over the world, from Japan to Iceland, scanning and capturing different objects and surfaces. Using a program called Reality Capture, these scans are then converted into 3D objects and imported into Unreal. They have been used in movies and TV shows like The Lion King and Mandalorian. What's amazing is that all these assets are free and built into Unreal Engine 5 by default. To get Megascans, all you have to do is click on the Add button right here and select Quixel Bridge. Now we get access to those 16,000 assets. So for example, what if we want a rock from the desert? Well, I'm going to select 3D assets to filter for objects and type in desert and then rock. So we see all the different assets that we can choose from. Let's say, for example, maybe I want this asset right here. All you have to do is drag it into your world, wait for it to download. And now we have that object ready to move around and place in our world. They even give us a lot of customizable features, such as changing the color of the rock. Or we can even make the rock a lot shinier. So let's get a better angle so the sun is hitting it right here by adjusting its max roughness. So maybe this rock is really wet, so it's really shiny. In fact, this environment I created is almost made up entirely of Megascan assets. From the houses to the foliage, all the way to the cliffs at the very far back, they are all from the library. Also, the desert from the Valley of the Ancients demo is entirely made up of Megascan assets. You can pretty much click anywhere on the screen, and odds are you have selected a real-life object that was scanned from the deserts of Utah. Reason number four is metahumans. Humans are one of the hardest assets to create for games and movies, especially if you're trying to create realistic humans. It is one of the most expensive parts of any production. This is why metahumans is amazing. It allows us to quickly create realistic humans in minutes, and the application runs on your computer browser, so you don't need to download Unreal Engine to use it. It also comes with a bunch of different preset humans. This is one of the preset humans. You can see that we have just a bunch of options at the left right here. We could go in and sculpt, maybe give him a bigger nose, and also raise the cheekbones. And then we could go into the head, give him different hair, and maybe even add in a mustache. And of course, change the proportions, maybe make him a little bit skinnier. Of course, we could continue using MetaHuman Creator, but what if we want to bring the human into UE5? Well, it's as easy as opening up Bridge and going into the MetaHumans tab. And under My MetaHumans, you see all the humans you have created. All you have to do is simply download that character and import it into your game. Once you do have it imported, you just have to find where he is under MetaHuman and simply drag it out. It is that easy now to create a realistic human for games and animation. But we're not just limited to a static human. We can animate pretty much everything about this MetaHuman, including his face. So for example, what if you want to move his mouth down? Just grab it like that, move it. You can also move his eyes, so you can see him looking in game. And keep in mind, all of these are animatable, so you could create an entire animation. We can even change his body's pose. So we could raise the arms and maybe try to animate him waving if you are good with animation. The Matrix Unreal Engine 5 demo is a great example of the power of metahumans. All the humans from the player character to the pedestrians walking the street are metahumans. Even Keanu Reeves is a customized metahuman. Instead of using the MetaHuman application, artists scan Keanu Reeves' face and then use the MetaHuman technology for the materials, rigging, and animation. So if you are a technical artist, you can still make use of MetaHuman in a more traditional pipeline. You're not just limited to what is possible in the MetaHuman editor. Number 5 is surprisingly Unreal Engine 4. You probably noticed that what you see on the screen right now is not Unreal Engine 5. This is a demo of Unreal Engine 4 that was released in 2012, which is a decade ago. The reason why I'm showing this is to demonstrate that UE4 projects can easily be converted into UE5 projects. Now, this is the same demo, but running in Unreal Engine 5, making use of all the new features, such as Lumen and Nanites. So it looks a lot better than it did in 2012. The reason why this is important is because all the content created for UE4 is still relevant and works for UE5. Whether that be tutorials or asset packs, there's already an existing and thriving Unreal ecosystem. For example, there are over 10,000 different asset packs you can buy right now on the Unreal Marketplace, and almost all of them can be converted to UE5. Not to mention a lot of these assets are free and new free content is being added every month. Also, almost all tutorials created for Unreal Engine 4 still apply to Unreal Engine 5, which is great for me because that means all my past videos are still relevant. For example, if you want to learn how to create a donut in Unreal Engine, then all you have to do is watch this Unreal Engine 4 video, and it still works for Unreal Engine 5. And if you want to learn Unreal Engine 5, then luckily you are in the right place. I have a free 5-hour long beginner tutorial, which you can watch right now, link in the description below. We go over everything from the basics of Unreal to creating a beautiful environment like the one you see right here. Feel free to check it out if you are interested in learning Unreal. Thousands of people have already completed that course and have started their Unreal journey through it. Also, since UE5 has now officially released, I have a bunch of content, videos, and assets planned for this channel. So if you're interested in that, make sure you subscribe and press the bell icon for notifications. With all that being said, I hope to see you in future videos.